And to be here with DeeDee, the grandmother of independent media, and to be here with my colleagues at Democracy Now!, Samine, who heads our education department now, Karen Renucci, who's chair of our board, Sam Alcock, our producer, Reed Brody, our lawyer, most recently around at Standing Rock. Democracy Now! Wouldn't be celebrating its 20th anniversary this year if Deep Dish weren't celebrating its 30th. When Democracy Now! Began in 1996, DeeDee came to us, I think in 1998 or 9, said you gotta do this on TV, and she was constantly trying to bring TV cameras into WBAI. We did an experiment at the Battle of Seattle, where we broadcast not only radio but television out of the basement of a church. And then the Philadelphia Convention. We broadcast together with Deep Dish and MNN, the whole team. We worked together to do a TV video broadcast, which was before we really launched on television. The following year, the week of September 11th, 2001, was when we started as emergency broadcasting on Manhattan Neighborhood Network. But it was Deep Dish. When stations all over the country started to ask for Democracy Now! Television, that made it possible. Because Deep Dish was the reservoir of information about all of these public access stations. We knew radio very well, but television, as the orders were coming in, it was Deep Dish that was making the reproductions of the video cassettes, and the FedEx guys would come and they look like Santa Claus with their plastic bags filled with video cassettes of orders that we would send out overnight because they thought it was breaking news, and so it had to get there not more than 24 hours later. And that's how Democracy Now! Began to grow. And it came really out of the wisdom of a very young Deep Dish TV, deeply committed to this idea of decentralized media, how we can connect the dots all over the country. How easily, when you start at the top and you just broadcast out on a network, you can be decapitated. But if you work at station after station and use the wisdom and the skills and the talents of people in their communities, they're experts in their own worlds. Instead of the pundits you get on television who know so little about so much, explaining the world to us and getting it so wrong. And to see George Stoney at the beginning, whose deep life commitment was about independent media, the whole idea of public access that still we must protect all over the country. It has been such a great honor to work together in this collaboration and to learn from those who are so committed to a grassroots global media. Just seeing all the images from the Philippines to Cuba, from Nicaragua to all over the United States. And it's the unique, authentic voices of people who've been struggling for so long that you just don't get. The corporate media now is going through this mass mea culpa moment, right? Because they're saying, how did we get it so wrong leading into this election? And they're blaming themselves for relying on faulty polls. That's as far as the criticism goes. It's not about, and this is why they're not gonna go any further, because they're just gonna try to improve their data journalism. It's not about the fact that just as before now, they're icing out the majority of voices in this country and around the world. They bring us this tiny slice of the minority elite, and I'm not talking about people of color, this small group of people, of these know-nothing pundits, where the richness and the breadth of people's lives is so rarely conveyed in these well-resourced media outlets, why we still have to simply build up, shore up, put our incredible passion and faith in these outposts in every community that people have fought for, built up, poured their passion into, public access television. So I'm so honored to be a part of this and to be a part of celebrating Deep Dish today, because Deep Dish is really where it all began for us, and we thank you so much, and let's continue. It is needed more now, more than ever.